यू आर गेटिंग 15, ऑलमोस्ट 15 क्वेश्चंस ऑफ मैच द कॉलम्स, लाइक यू हैव हेयर एंड देन यू हैव हेयर एंड यू हैव टू मैच इट. एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट पीपल आर गेटिंग, मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट एक्चुअली गॉट दैट, रिस्क स्ट्रेटेजी. हाउ मेनी रिस्क स्ट्रेटेजी आर देयर इन प्रिडिक्टिव वन एंड दे मैच इट. ओके, like positive risk strategy, negative risk strategy, the scenario, we exactly had the same type of question, if you guys remembered. Remember?
Yep.
Yeah. So that type of
yes, question, yes.
That type of questions are coming more and more. So 15 questions, you can say, are still there. So you can match accordingly. Sorry? Saira is here? No, she is not here. Okay. Any question or I can go with the revision?
Yes, I think we should start with the revision.
Yeah.
For everyone who came later, the purpose of this section is basically to just act like a master class and revise the high-level concept of Agile. Okay. Review each and everything and see where we stand, and everyone have a proper understanding. The most of the data I will be using is that you guys have made it and shared it with me, like mind maps and all those things. And I would just like to share something that I gave you task to share me also the mind map of predictive environment. Only one person shared it with me. I am still missing that. So it will be great if you guys who have made the mind map of predictive environment, if they can share so that everyone can learn and plus I can see where you actually stand. Okay.
Hi, Amir. Yeah. I have just small question. Yes, what is this exactly mind map? Because I was not into the class.
Good question. So mind map is more like a map in which you connect each and everything. So why don't I start with the mind map? Okay. You guys can see whiteboard?
Oh.
Yes.
Instead of whiteboard, we have that presentation. We can.
So, Amir, one question just.
Yeah.
So for the predictive, right? So for each chapter wise, like cost, schedule, scope. So for that, we can have one mind map, right?
Okay.
Instead of having all complete predictive chapters, we can have it, right?
Yeah. Both are okay. Both systems are okay.
Yes.
Okay. So let's move.
You can see this.
Okay. That's good. So everyone, I would ask from any person and they will tell me what does this topic means, and then we can move forward. So Ishtiaq, what is information radiator? And give me an example of information radiator.
So information radiators are tools which we use to display our information related to the project activities going on.
Mm-hmm.
Like we display the sticky notes for displaying things going in progress, which are in, you know, development stage, which are completed, to be completed. So whatever the information regarding the ongoing project activities, especially pertaining to sprint.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Sprint cycle. So mm-hmm. that are called the information radiators. Like they radiate the information.
Okay. Can you give an example?
Like Kanban board.
Okay, good.
One of the information. And Kanban board.
Yeah. And?
I can't just skip the name.
No issue. Okay, Nirich, what is team space and what are the rules for co-location?
So, team space is basically the space where the team is located, like co-location, where all teams are located at one physical place.
Okay. And what is the size of that physical space generally?
I mean, it is 25 meters.
33 feet or 10 meter.
Okay.
It's like a big hole. So we have agile tooling. Okay, that's okay. So Saili, what is osmotic communication?
I am Mir. I'm not aware of it actually.
Okay, no issue. So you haven't revised the agile area yet? You are working on predictive?
Not yet. Okay. Yes, I'm still on predictive.
Okay, so Farhan, what is osmotic communication?
Osmotic communication is the co-located and same as a team space where team members sit between the distance of 33 feet, so people can listen what they are talking and like each other, and we can get the information while someone talking over the phone or talking to someone rather than asking questions, so we can get the information.
Thank you. Right now, me and Farhan is talking, and all of you can actually listen to it. This is the good example of osmotic communication. Okay, so this is an example of osmotic communication. Okay, Bio, what is daily stand-up?
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Daily stand-up is one of the major events during Scrum, which comes during the sprint activities. Each day, at the same location, at same time and same duration of 15 minutes, team come together and they consider what they have done during the last sprint, what they are doing, what are going to do during this current sprint, and what are the impediments, that is on their way to achieve what they want to achieve. Basically, team come together, discuss 15 minutes, same time, same place, and discuss these three major issues.
Okay. So who is present in daily stand-up?
Daily stand-up, basically, daily stand-up is for the teams. Okay. But you can have the product owner and the Scrum Master over there, but they are not to make any contribution. But however, the Scrum Master is to ensure that they follow the principles of Agile and it gives them the right guidance for, using the Agile approach.
So if I have a question, regarding that time, can I ask counter question or another question in that time? During sprint?
Strictly for the three questions. Strictly for the three questions. No other questions.
So if I have something follow up, what would I do?
You can bring it up during the review, but not for the daily stand-up.
No. Apart from that, your understanding is very good. I really like that. For everyone, if you have a follow-up question with any person that you want to discuss, what is the way that you have a follow-up meeting with that person? For example, you want to discuss some risk, you get with that person on the team, and then you discuss those things. So this is very important. You will get questions regarding daily stand-up. And one more thing, while we are going through these topics, if anyone has any question regarding any topic, they can ask, okay? So let's move to the next slide. Okay, so.
Agile tooling, sir?
Yeah, Bio?
The agile tooling.
Yeah, that will come. That's why I put it, I didn't discuss it. No? Asim?
Yes.
What is retrospective?
So sprint retrospectives are the last, or iteration retrospectives are the last step of an iteration. This is where the team sits together and discusses all the lessons learned, everything they've learned, everything that was missing, and their experiences during the complete sprint. They discuss that.
Okay. So how many steps does retrospective have?
How many steps?
Yeah.
I can't recall that.
Anyone can tell me? Anyone?
Can I? Yep. So it's a set the stage. Data gathering. Data gathering.
Okay.
And then we get decide what to do, and then sprint close the sprint, I think it's timeline discussion.
Yeah. So can you repeat yourself? There are five steps. You said four. You missed one step. once again, please.
Okay, so it's at the stage, data gathering, and timeline.
No. Timeline is a technique.
Timeline is a technique.
So set the stage, generate.
Set
the stage, gather data, generate insights. What to do, and close the sprint. Closing it. Okay. So these are the five stages. Set the stage, gather data, generate insights, decide what to do, and close the sprint. Thank you very much, Pranav sir. Okay. So, Umair, what is task board and Kanban board?
Yes, the task and Kanban boards is a tool in this agile method where we put our task in this what to do. Mm-hmm. And what we need to, what is in process and what is means finish. Mm-hmm. So it's a pull based method to prioritize and check the job. Mm-hmm. And what we need to do and what we will need to focus in process and what needs to be closed.
Okay, so what is the difference
this between task
board and Kanban board?
Both are same because this is a technique to check the job means. Okay. What we have done and what we need to do.
Okay. So both are same.
Yes.
Are you sure? Anyone can tell me the difference?
Can I go? Hassan Hussain.
Yeah, Hassan, please.
Yeah, task boards are basically just the task that we have to do. Like to do in the product backlog, the tasks we have to do. The to do and done. But the Kanban boards also show the work in progress. Which are the tasks that are currently under work in progress. So we try to limit the number of tasks in WIP so that we don't have any bottlenecks or any wait so we can keep the flow at a steady pace.
So 50% of what you said was right. Okay. Both these can be said as this is basically task board and this is also Kanban board. It becomes Kanban board when we put work in progress limit here. We need to put work in progress limit here. Is it clear to everyone?
It's not clear.
Yes, clear.
We need to put, you see, Umair, that this is a task board to do in progress done. Let's say to do is, like we have 10 user stories in progress is like right now 2 user stories and done we have done 5 tasks in task board. We are just showing the progress. Okay, we are not limiting anything. We are not making a pull system as per se. The task board is just showing you the progress, what is happening, whereas the Kanban board actually work on pull system by limiting the work in the progress. The Kanban board says that currently only this much work can be done. This, by limiting the work in progress, it says only this much work can be in progress at one time. Is it clear now?
Yes, now it's okay.
Anyone want to discuss difference between task and Kanban board? Any issue? You can get a question regarding that in exam. Okay.
Yeah, task board one more time, Jilix. Exactly. In short.
Yeah, sure. Just one second. So what is task board and what is Kanban board? This is very important because Kanban board is a methodology that is used and you will get a question regarding it one way or another. So simple as it gets, this is task board to do work in progress or whatever, and done. You can make as many columns as you want. So task board just showed the progress. Okay. It is just showing that how much work is done, what is work in progress, what is done. Okay. If you want Kanban board, what will happen? You will limit your work in progress. Whatever you want to limit, you limit the work in progress. Like currently you can only do one task. Right now I have written here one. You can only take one task from here. And unless that task is done, you cannot take more tasks from to do.
So okay.
Limited the work in progress. And once this is done, it will move here and automatically we will pull the task from here. Okay. So we are in Kanban, we are actually establishing the pull based system by limiting work in progress. Clear, Prakash? Prakash, clear?
Yeah, mate. So the content means the to do, work in progress, and done, both these columns will be same in both.
Yeah, both are same. Both are
only
same. Work in progress. Yeah, limit is there. Yeah,
limit is there only.
Yeah, bio.
What is the limit? One touch, two touch, three touch, or
you can limit time? Whatever you want. Like if you have only one developer,
the team, right? The team places the limit, right?
Yeah, you limit. You by understanding how much you work can do one time, you limited yourself. It can be one task, it can be two tasks, you two user stories, it can be 10 user stories, whatever you want to limit, you limit it. You see?
Okay.
Yeah, clear bio?
Clear.
Anyone want to ask any other question?
Amirai, what is Kanban swim lane? Swim lane.
Yeah, swim lane is like when all the teams start working together. Let's say we have four developers and now we are stuck with the work in progress. We cannot move forward. So all teams start working on one task or on one area together. That is known as swim lane. We swim together. Okay. You have seen the animals swimming together. So it came from there that everyone swim together. So this, they called it swim lane. Okay, clear? Yeah, bio?
Sorry, I didn't get that word. Can you write it? That word, swim lane?
Yeah, there is a terminology known as swim lane. I'm not sure about the spelling, but it means that everyone work on one task. Like if there are five team members, they start working on that task. So that they can.
Swimming in the water.
No. That I was just giving an analogy.
So is this swimming between these columns?
Yeah.
So they finish one work, then they move all together to the next.
Yeah. So they work on this, all swim lane. They work together and move forward. So Faransab, I know that you are very good at agile. Please do not confuse people.
No, because I've seen that one question in one of the.
Yeah, bio.
So the criteria for swim lanes is for the bottleneck tasks or for any work in progress task.
Generally, it is used for bottleneck task, but it can be used by any task. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, bio, still have any question?
So Amit, this is a Kanban only, right? This word comes under?
No. It is in agile, in complete agile.
Okay, generic word. Okay.
Yeah, in complete agile.
Okay.
It can be compared to resource.
Crashing.
Yes, resource optimization, right? We can add more resources.
Yeah. You can make analogy like that.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So Hasan, explain me time boxing, iteration, and release planning.
Time boxing is limiting the duration of the task, putting a duration constraint on the task, like which tasks are to be done in how much time. Like if we are talking about the sprint, the time boxing of a sprint is usually 1 to 4 weeks, but the team can decide. Usually the team decides how much time it requires for a sprint. So iteration and release planning is the same. Like we plan the release, how many releases we are going to have, and how many sprints each release will contain.
Okay.
And WIP limits already has been.
Okay, work in progress limit we already discussed.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's, okay. Shazib, what is burn down, burn up chart?
Sir, burn down and burn up chart is to check where we are standing, to check the analysis, what is going on, to check, just to analyze, comparing with the plan and actual, what work is remaining and what is not.
Okay. And what is the difference between burn up and burn down?
Sir, burn down is means how work at first we are at zero at the top, then goes down remaining work. Okay. And burn up display us what is the difference between actual cost burn up chart, just bottom to top.
Okay, if in which you can see the scope has been added or removed.
Scope is basically in burn down.
Burn up chart, yes. Now we can see in burn up chart that scope has been added or removed. Okay, thank you very much. Can you also tell me what is cumulative flow diagram?
I need to recall cumulative flow diagram.
Anyone can tell me cumulative flow diagram?
So how many user stories we have completed up till now? All those will get added as and when we progress to our iterations, right?
Okay. Release. Okay. So anyone else? What is cumulative flow diagram?
So I think it's more of a diagram, a flow chart of a sort. It shows that how much work is being done currently.
Okay, good.
It's something like that.
We can put Kanban board into cumulative flow diagram. You see, done, how much work is done, we can put here, work in progress, like we can make different partitions and how much to do. So we can make a diagram like this. You can put here how much have to do. So in this way, you can visually see from the Kanban board, you can make a graph and you can see how much work is in progress, and this becomes the bottleneck then. Okay, just a visual way to see how much work is done. And similarly, from this is basically made of burn up chart. It's kind of a burn up chart with a
chart.
There you can use it from Kanban board. Simply all the data it has, you can make a cumulative flow diagram. And it is also used for risk, actually. Risk cumulative, how many risk has occurred, how many risk are still to occur, how many identified, and you can make something for it. Okay, any question? So it's a good tool to understand cumulative flow diagram.
So this is it's a burn up chart plus additional information.
It's a burn up chart. It has been tailored. Burned up chart has been tailored. So this also covers the next topic, the tailor. Okay. So let's move to the next topic. Okay. So relative sizing or story points. Asim, can you light on that?
Yes. So story points is basically a way to define that how many stories are completed. So it defines the velocity. For example, if a team completes 10 story points or 10 stories in one sprint, so their story points would be 10. And this is how the velocity is defined, basically.
Good, well done. So what is story point? What difference between...
So a story point is that it's basically, for example, if one user story is there are two user stories, one user story should take, for example, 10 weeks and one user story takes 5 weeks. So we can say, okay, user story one has 10 story points and user story two has 5 story points, something like this. We can tell anything about anything, but to define what's the difference between the size of different user stories. Okay. It can be money or something, but it should be something same and to differentiate between the size of different user stories.
Okay, thank you.
Can I add, Amir?
Sure.
Yeah. So story points, basically we are following that Fibonacci series. One, two, three, and means 1 + 2, 3, then 3 + 2, 5, and 1, 2, 3, 5, that sequence.
Good.
Just to compare the comparison, relative comparison between one stories with the one user story with another, like how complex is the, we can just compare the complexity of this user story.
Well done, well done. Anyone else would like to add something in this topic? It's a very important topic from exam point of view. Farhan? Okay.
I think it's all
size, and also that's where we'll talk about having large, medium, large, just a comprehensive.
Yes.
You know how big this
skill point is. We use t-shirt sizing. Yeah, bio, good way. We use sizing to put large, XL. Okay. So, Ishtiaq, can you tell me what is wideband Delphi?
Actually, wideband Delphi is an estimation technique.
Okay.
For with this technique, we estimate about the efforts we in completing a user story.
Okay.
If I can recall it, you know exactly. Okay. There's the effort estimation technique for the user story.
Okay. Good.
And with that effort sizing, definitely we can convert it to our, you know, the monitoring estimation, how much resources will be used for the how much times and this.
Okay, it's an estimation technique, but it's a secret consensus points. Okay, so we take
secret consensus.
Yeah, we ask secretly how much, like maybe I ask Shariar by message, what do you think, how many points, story points would be this user story? Shariar says 2. Then I ask Shazeb secretly, Shazeb says 15. Now there's a gulf of evaluation between two of these people. So I will ask both of them why they think this way, and then we will slowly move towards a consensus where we can have a consensus, okay, on the story points. Let's say one expert is saying 2 story points, the other expert is saying 15 story points about the same user story. Now it's a big difference, right, everyone?
Yes.
So if we want, then we will ask the person who said why he thinks it should be 2 story point. Then we will ask why the person who said 15, maybe he knows some risk that the other person does not know. So then we communicate secretly to that. Once he understand that, then we will ask again, both of them to re-estimate. We keep on estimating unless we get to a maybe a neutral point of estimation. Clear? Okay, and same thing is actually planning poker. In planning poker, we take cards out. Okay, why don't you explain, Neeraj, what is planning poker?
So planning poker is basically a consensus-based estimation technique. So generally agile teams use this poker to estimate their product backlogs. Anonymously, they ask the team members to provide their estimate, and then they then make the consensus.
So the team sit together. Maybe on the count of 3, whatever you can say, on the count of 3, all team members take their cards out. The cards are based on Fibonacci series 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13. So let's say Shazeb put out a card of user story 1, whereas Neeraj put a card of user story 13. Now that's a difference. So both of them, they will discuss why they think 13, why they take 1. Then again, they will put out the card, this time the new information. So in this way, you build a consensus for the user story's estimation. Good. So what is
the difference between planning poker and wideband, since one is secret, why the other one is not?
Yeah, the difference can be because the one person who is saying 13, he knows some risk, he knows some difficulties that the other person does not know. So once he communicate that with the team, maybe now the team will re-estimate, maybe they will increase their estimates. Okay? So Bio, what is affinity estimation?
If I remember, affinity estimation. I think it's one of the ways of estimating. I can't really pick.
Okay, let's say there are 50 user stories placed this way, no? So what do? You make columns. You say that all the user stories which you think are small, you placed in this column. All the user stories which you think medium, place here. Which you think extra large, place here. Okay, so everyone, the team will put small user stories here, and they have categorized the user stories in a very no time. So this is known as simply affinity estimating.
Sir, it's just like affinity diagrams dividing into 100%, groups.
100% it's an affinity diagram. Okay.
It's just dividing into groups.
They are categorizing them. Categorizing. Yeah,
just.
Okay.
So is it same as t-shirt size?
Yeah.
Thing or?
We can use t-shirt size.
This is t-shirt.
Yeah, we can use 1-3 Fibonacci series here. We can use, like, say, small cup, big cup, whatever you want to use. Okay. So ideal time. Farhan, what is ideal time?
Very good question. I don't know.
Okay, thank you. Okay, when we are estimating, most of the time the team estimates in ideal time. When we say five story points, 10 story points, they count that all the time. Let's say if we are working for 4 hours or 8 hours, they don't count distraction. They don't count drinking time. They don't count coffee time. They consider that all the time they will be working. Okay. So once you don't count distractions, you only count the time as general, that if it's 8 hours, you will be continuously working for that time. This is known as ideal time. Okay. So most of the time, if the ideal time is 40 hours, let's say, actually it will take 45 or maybe 50 hours to complete the work. The remaining 5-10 hours will be counted as distraction and all those things. And in this way, as the team moves, their velocity start getting stabilized. They start getting those things into that. Clear to everyone?
Thank you. Yes.
Okay. Anyone put a question here? I am unable to see questions. They can ask, please.
Yes, sir. This is Omer Ansari. Is there any difference means between relative sizing and affinity? By definition, it seems that both are segregating and categorizing.
All estimations in Agile are relative. All estimations in Agile are relative estimation. We don't have definite estimate in Agile. Is this clear?
A lot of time question came, and if, for example, in a question, then you have two options on what basis you will select relative sizing and affinity. At that time, we need to differentiate now.
No. You will not get a question that saying that if the question says that you have categorized. Initially, you have identified all the user stories and now you have categorized them. The categorized is always in affinity estimating. Relative sizing is a way how you do it. Affinity estimation is a technique. Okay. Relative sizing is a way how you do estimation. Affinity is a tool and technique for that. You can use affinity estimating, you can use planning poker, you can use vibe band, you can use t-shirt sizing. All these are techniques. All these techniques actually used relative sizing. Okay.
Okay. Now got it. Thank you.
Yeah, Shazib.
Sir, I have a bit confusion in relative sizing as story points. Please explain again.
You just relatively size them. No? Let's say we have t-shirts. You can take any size. You can take any size, whatever you want. Like, for example, the very famous is t-shirt sizing or bulldog sizing. Like Mike Cohan, he says that he take the example of small dog, big dog, the bigger dog, because they actually have pet dogs there. Na? So they use dog comparison. You can use whatever comparison. Okay. So you use comparison. Okay. This user story is, we say it is small user story. Then we say that this is large story. So user, the second story which we are saying it's large story, it must be larger than the small one. Okay, Shazib?
Okay, fine.
This way we use relatively sizing. We can also use Fibonacci series for relatively sizing. 1, 3, 5, 8, 13. Okay, thank you.
One more, this on idle time, I just didn't focus, I guess. I just forgot.
You don't count distraction time. Okay, for example, yesterday you guys did questions, 30 questions, and you estimated that you will complete, let's say, 90 seconds for one question and you will complete it in 45 minutes. But actually, how much time you took?
Two hours, one and a half hours.
45 hours. You didn't count any kind of distraction, but actually it took you 2 hours. Clear?
Oh, got it. Oh, so... Yeah. So just removing lunch time and all those basic tea time, those time, removing actual working hours.
Idle time eliminate. Idle time basically says that all the time you are working. You consider that all the time I'm working. Okay.
Like with normal planning, we normally do like 6 hours. Although the people working, like working hour, 8 hours, but you do, we call it a 6 hour working time.
You know, that becomes a different thing. If you plan for ideal, when you are planning for ideal time, you will consider 8 hours.
Okay, opposite.
You will consider opposite. 8 hours. It's the opposite of what you are saying. 8 hours. But actually what will happen, as a result, you estimated you will complete in 40 hours, but as a result, you complete in 46 hours. Then you find out, okay, or ideal estimation, these 6 hours were actually distractions. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
So we'll add buffer time also, ideal, right? In idle time. It will have actual working plus buffer time.
We have no buffer time. No buffer time. We show that this is buffer time, but in a general, we don't put any buffer time.
Mention it. Okay. Right.
So product roadmap. What is product roadmap, Prakash?
So this come under in Scrum where we... Scrum only, right? Yeah. In Scrum where we have the... How will we develop the product in step-by-step manner, like...
And which technique we use for product roadmap? Story maps. So, we use story maps to make like these is release one, release two, release three. Things like that. Okay, Bio, what is user story?
It's called user stories. As an engineering department, we want a new smartphone with sensitive camera so that we can gain 25% market share.
Okay. So that's what you are telling is a syntax of a user story. Actually, what is a user story?
Well, a user story, it's just like a definition of what is to be done that will be written on a card. Conversation, and at the back you have confirmation, which should be the definition of the done.
3C, card, you have conversation, this is conversation, and the third C is confirmation. What is bioconfirmation?
That's the definition of the done.
Definition, good, thank you very much. Okay. Umair, what is progressive elaboration?
Progressive elaboration is a technique to proceed further and getting the inputs include in our product so to improve further. So as the project progress, we'll get the more information to proceed.
Okay, good. Hassan?
We'll get more information.
Thank you. Hassan?
Yes.
Wireframes.
I don't remember that.
The wireframe is a low fidelity prototype. They are used to show the client the design like this. Like I am making this by hand. You can show the client maybe on iPad, on a whiteboard, or by just...
Prototypes.
Yeah, low fidelity prototype design, you show them. Prakash, why don't you explain what I'm saying? I think you want to.
So in short, right? What all...
In short.
Just explaining in short, yeah.
Explain, please.
So wireframes, I'm also not sure, but yeah. So based on whatever we discussed, I think it's like in shorter way just to explain to product owner that this all has been achieved in a shorter way, like a presentation, small presentation.
Yeah, I remember it now. Can I?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, wireframes are the like we are creating a web page or the whatever product we are creating, web page or the or an app. We show the customer how it's going to work. Like if like we are creating the UI, we show the customer on paper. We create a UI user interface of the product, and we add all the elements which are required in the product, and we show the customer how each element will work, and then we further categorize and we further explain and create more wireframes for each interaction.
Okay, good. So low, just for mock-up or as a minimum viable product, we can show the customer that the work will be done. This, let's say you are making a website that will has so many things, so you can show in the form of pages. Good, thank you. So signing,
sir, I think it's
like basic sketch.
Yeah, sketch, good word to use. Yes,
handmade. We can, sir, handmade sketches of website, just to ensure what is.
Yes, 100%. Okay, Silik.
Blueprint, Amir, can we say blueprint?
Blueprint is more refined form, isn't it, Neeraj?
Blueprint is a kind of sample or template
we can say, but whatever, I think you understand that's important. Silik?
Yeah.
Hi, Amir. Yes.
What is charting? Now, charting is in both agile charting and project charting. So just general, what is charting? You know that. We discussed this.
Charting is, I guess, it's initiation of beginning of the project or process.
Okay.
Or any phase.
Okay. So charting.
Because from predictive world, I know that charting.
Is a starting the project, you document it or you make a paper that which authorize the project. The thing which authorize the project is a chartering. Okay, Asim, what is persona?
So persona is basically looking at someone and according to his attitude and something, making some assumptions about someone, that how they will, according to their character or according to their attitude, what they like, what they don't like and stuff like that.
Good, thank you. So we all know in quality, we get frequent verification and validation. We get daily stand-ups for that and we get sprint review for that. So now we have test-driven development, also known as test-first development or acceptance test development. So who can explain me? Please unmute yourself and explain me test-driven development. What is that?
So okay, I can explain.
In test-driven developments, what I understand is, for example, during a pair programming, where you have to run a test, then work on the code. Like you're trying to, bring out your errors before you actually, get the code
running. Thank you. Okay. Who else was asking? You were explaining?
Yes. So basically, test-driven development is where you create the tests first. Mm-hmm. And you create the test first, and then according to the tests, you create your code so that your code can pass those tests. You create all sorts of tests, integration tests, unit tests, boundary tests, so that once the tests are ready, then you start developing your design or code.
Good. Anyone else would like to add something? Okay.
And just a question. I understand boundary tests, unit tests. Can you please just throw a light on it?
Yeah, what you said was right. What was the
like? So you're asking what a unit test is?
Yeah.
So basically, in software development, it's a term, it's used. So you have a complete system, and then inside system, you have small units. Yeah. So instead of testing the complete big system, you test the small units out of it. So that's unit testing.
Okay.
So unit testing is basically for the developers. So whenever they are writing their code, they just make that unit testing script so that they can validate the small code, their own code, instead of testing complete integration system. Just a small, small chunk of code.
Now we are, Prakash, we are moving to that. What is continuous integration? Prakash?
Yeah, continuous integration is so whenever any small piece is done, then we integrate that piece with the remaining other stuff, and we just check the flow whether from one system to another system data is flowing properly or not.
Yeah,
and we are integrating code based on our product. We just integrate our code inside those.
So we look at how it fits into the bigger picture. Good.
Yeah.
Okay, then Neeraj, what is emotional intelligence?
So emotional intelligence means that how a project manager or any team member works in a stressful environment, what is his reaction on that, and how his emotions plays, you know.
Good. So it is four steps. Yeah. First, know yourself. Second, manage yourself. Third, know others. Fourth, manage others, influence others, understand others, whatever you want to say. Collaboration, we collaborate with others. Adaptive leadership, as we move, we adopt accordingly. Negotiate, we always focus on win-win. Conflict resolution. So whenever you are solving the conflict, first you identify what is the stage of the conflict. Can anyone tell me the five stages of conflict? Level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, level 5. Hasan, can you?
Can I go?
Yeah, please.
First of all, define the it's conflict resolution, right?
Yes. 5 level of conflicts. Okay. We have level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, and level 5. Yeah?
I was gonna tell about problem solving.
Level five is war. That's the highest. Yeah.
Level one is disagreement. Okay. So this is important. Please go through that. And a project manager need to evaluate at which level the conflict is. And then he needs to participate in that to see how he can get a win-win situation. Okay. Hasan, can you tell me what is servant leaders?
Servant leader is for the project team, is a project manager or agile coach who is not basically managing or managing the team. It's basically for facilitating the team. He provides all the things that are required for the team to accomplish in the tasks, and for completing their tasks to for the development of the project, and make sure that no interruptions are causing, no external interruptions are causing the project team to delay their work.
Remember one thing, a servant leader cannot instruct, cannot order. If you are solving a question, any word saying instruct, order, he basically asks, he suggests, he requests, he things like that. Okay, so Neeraj, what is return on investment, IRR? Can you put light on that? NVP and payback period, what are these things?
I think these are the terms through which we gauge the benefit out of making the investment.
Yeah.
So
what is basically payback period? If the payback period is, the question says that the payback period of project A is 16 months, the payback period of a project B is 12 months. Which one you do?
So 12 months, obviously.
Good. So if the ROI of A is more, then?
That's fine, because ROI is greater than it means it's good.
Okay. So similarly, you move towards that which have more IRR and more net present value. Okay. Bio, what is minimum marketable features? Or minimum viable product, MVP?
Well, that's what we have to achieve to give to our customer to use.
Yeah, please go ahead.
With the smallest value. Yeah. And usually we get this during
when we deliver it
in this demonstration,
we give it sprint preview. Yeah, and we have to give
must have features. Sir.
Yeah. Okay, let's move forward. So risk adjusted backlog. Umair, what is risk adjusted backlog?
Means during the backlog, if we cannot finish the our task, so in that if we have a means unknown factor or unknown factors.
Can you repeat yourself? I think you confused two things. You mixed two things. Can you repeat?
Means in the risk adjusted backlog means during the means. Sprint review meeting when we are prioritizing the user stories.
Okay. Yeah. Then
the team will include the means risk so that it can be avoided to get the task and means to get the means to check that they can complete the sprint or not.
Your understanding is right, but you are unable to put in words. So let me help you. In the backlog, we adjust all the items according to the risk and high value. And we try to give high value, high risk item as soon as possible. Okay? We adjust the backlog as the high risk, high value items. And we deliver high risk, high value item as soon as possible. Is this clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay. So, to ask my okay, Shazib, what is risk burn down graph?
So burn down graphs are just so moving down. What is the risk impact on the work, and we have to remove after implementation of their strategies.
Okay. So what is risk based spike?
Spike is basically, if I remember spike, sorry, I don't remember.
Who can tell me what is risk spike?
It's a spike which comes due to some risk.
Unknown.
No.
Velocity. Where risk are higher.
Okay.
Unknown information.
Can I say what the risk spike is?
No. Okay. Asim, you got the answer from that side.
So you're not getting the threat.
I already know what a risk spike is, basically.
No, I'm saying your child is saying no, so you cannot answer. Okay.
So basically, a risk spike is an iteration or something which is done to verify or see what the risk of something is in a project, to check, to find out risks or to define how difficult the risk would be or something.
Good. Thank you. So velocity, we have already discussed. Cycle time is the time. Okay. Neeraj, what is cycle time?
Sorry, Amir, I don't recall.
Okay, Umair?
No, also I'm not able to recall.
Okay. Pransa?
It's an iteration time, like to complete the sprint.
Okay. Time it takes to complete a product.
It takes to complete the product.
Like in the Kanban, we had to do work in progress and done. Okay. The time it takes from to do to done is known as cycle time. Okay, sometimes. Okay, so anyone has any confusion in that? Okay, then we have earned value. Okay, bio, what is escape defects?
Escape defects are just those defects that while we're working, we're unable to detect them and they get into the final products of what we have done.
Okay. So value stream mapping is mapping of the complete process, trying to remove the non-value added values. Okay, so everyone is familiar about Moscow. This is clear, na? Any question about Moscow? Any question about Moscow?
No, it's clear.
Must have, should have, could have. Shazib, please stop playing with the. Okay, so we have what is agile project management and traditional project management. Now I will just give an overview, and if anyone has any confusion, they can tell me. Like, we have product backlog. From product backlog, we made sprint backlog. Then we have sprint. We give the final product. This is basically simply Scrum. Okay, these are the Kanban boards with the work in progress limit. Okay, so what happened in Scrum? You have product owner, you have a team, Scrum master, you sprint planning 1 to 4 week, daily Scrums, team discuss, and this is a discussion. Saili, is this page clear to you?
Yes, Amit.
If this is clear to you, then you already know the Agile. All the tools which we discussed today, and these things which we are going to discuss in next 10 minutes, if this is clear to you, your Agile is good to go. Okay?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So we have four. First, we have to make Agile mindset. That Agile is not just something that you make a mind. Like, you accept the change. That's a mind. You welcome change. You don't like documentation. That's a mindset. So once you have a mindset, then you go for the four values. Okay. Then 12 principle. Then we have Scrum. We have Kanban, Scrum Ban, we have Agile Frameworking, we have XP, we have Lean, 4 or 5 things, nothing more. Then we have this task board, Kanban board, we have story mapping, story release, user stories, daily Scrum. Everyone is familiar? Shazib, Jojo is Kupur, are you familiar with that?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Now I took the liberty of what you guys have made and I put it here. So if all of you can read this. Scrum is clear. We have covered Scrum, XP, Kanban, Lean, and what is missing here? No, I think it's enough. Okay. Then Agile values, 4 Agile values. You must know 12 principle. Okay. These are the important thing. Now, who made this? This is beautiful. Lean, Scrum, XP, the principle, the values, the framework, the Kanban, all these things. Please take a minute to just reflect on this paper. And if you are familiar with everything, you are good to go. You're good to go.
Unfortunately, me, I done it.
Thank you, sir. So please spend a minute on this.
Yes.
So this is another way to look at it. Who made this one? It's a good thing, yaar. Who made it?
Yeah, I made this, Hassan,
thank you. Yes. You have,
this one is very good.
This one is even, I would say, more clear. You have product owner. You must know what is the role of product owner. What is the role of Scrum Master? What is the role of developer or team? Then you have, Hassan, you have 5 events. Sprint planning meeting. Then you have daily stand-up, sprint review, sprint retrospective, and product backlog. Okay, you have artifact, 3 artifacts, product backlog, sprint backlog, increment. You have product goal, sprint goal, definition of done. Then you have user stories, you write user stories, card, conversation, confirmation. User stories must follow this independent, negotiable, valuable, estimatable. Then Scrum principles, transparency, inspection, adoption, values of Scrum, commitment, focus, openness, respect. Then you have Kanban, task pull based, to do, in progress, done. Hassan, please put number here. Okay, some number there. That maybe, okay. And here, it will be more. 4 values of Agile: individual and interaction or processes and tool, working software or comprehensive documentation, customer collaboration, responding to change. Then we have 12 values here, 12 principles here, satisfying the customer satisfaction and all these things. Then we have XP, values of XP, communication, feedback, courage, respect. There's one more value: communication, feedback, courage, respect, openness.
Hassan? Focus.
Focus, yeah, focus. Focus. Openness, okay. Come here, yeah, focus. Focus or openness, one value more there. Then principle. Okay, for everyone. Now I'm saying this principle. If you are not principal, clear with this principle, please open your mic and ask me. Pair programming, co-located teams, planning games, small release, collective code of ownership, standardized code, sustainable pace, metaphor, simple design, customer test or UAT, continuous integration, test-driven refactoring. Refactoring is simplifying. Then in here, we, instead of Scrum Master, we actually say coach, mentor, guide, facilitator. Instead of product owner, we have a customer here. And we have team here, and testers are also there. So let's go with the lean. So this was all about XP. Then lean. Lean have 7 values. Where is the value?
I don't get metaphor.
Bio, I could not hear you.
Metaphor.
Bio, metaphor. Yeah, metaphor is like nickname. Like two members are working, they use kind of a nickname to come and that everyone can understand. Okay? Any name, any nickname, anything, metaphor, any analogy they utilize that everyone can understand. Okay, if I want to say someone as a leader and I say Nelson Mandela, now everyone understand Nelson Mandela. I say leadership and Nelson Mandela. We are using metaphor for that. Clear, bio? Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
So 7 values: eliminate waste, empower the team, deliver fast, optimize the whole, build quality in deferred decision, decide on the last moment, amplify learning. Then we have waste, partially done work, extra process, extra feature, task switching, waiting, motion, defects. We have crystal, crystal clear, crystal yellow, crystal orange. Guys, if you can master this page, well done, Asan. If you can master this page and understand it, you can actually clear all the agile question. If you understand it, embody all these things. No? Excellent work, man. Okay. So who made this one?
Coach, can I ask one question?
Yeah, sure. Let me put it back. Ask.
Yes, sir. In the event, this backlog grooming, can we consider as an event in Scrum or?
There are 5 events in the Scrum. Okay. So backlog is an event, but let me just get back to you because I am not recalling the 5th event. The 4 he has written, the 5th.
Backlog grooming and refinement.
Yeah, I think product backlog refinement is the 5th event. Just give me a moment, I will get back to you. Okay. So who made this one?
It's me, sir.
Shazib, let me check. This is also seems to be good. Okay. Oh, it's even better. You have a Kanban board here and Shazib put a number here. Kanban work on pull system, work completed, next, good, well done. Then you visualize the workflow, limit WPU, manage the workflow, collaboration, well done. Then we in XP, we have customer, okay. XP role, simplicity, communication, feedback, planning games, release, code ownerships, okay, good. Feature driven, okay, we have features. Waiting, okay, core principle, good, crystal clear, well done, metaphor, coded, 12 principles, satisfy the customer. Where is Scrum? Okay, this is Scrum. Scrum artifact, product backlog, sprint backlog, the product back, this is not a Scrum artifact, Shazib. We have 3, product backlog, sprint backlog, and product increment. These are the 3 artifacts. Sprint planning, development, daily Scrum, you need to review this one. No? It's good, but it needs a little bit of review from you. Okay?
Okay.
So now I took this sheet from somewhere. Okay. 4 values of Agile. It also gives the same thing which you guys have already mentioned. Okay. So, Umair, sprint planning.
Yes, sir.
These are the sprint planning. This is what happened in daily Scrum. This is product backlog. This is sprint review, sprint retrospective. Sahil, is it helpful? Sahil, are you with me? No, she is not here. Okay, guys, this is clear?
Yeah, this one is very good, yeah.
These are 5 events. Umair, sprint planning.
Yes, yes.
Daily Scrum, product backlog refinement, sprint review, retrospective. Okay. So here, just to give you another view, inputs, users, we make product, we have product backlog, then the team decide, we have then sprint backlog, we move throughout the backlog, we give MVP, after 24 hours, we have daily stand up and we move on this. Okay. This is also clear. We have product owner scrum. We start from here. We identify the vision, project vision. Then we get goals. Then we manage epics. Then we have user stories. Okay. And we move this way. Okay. Good. Okay. Let's focus more on scrum now. Okay. So we have, this is a very good slide. Three roles, everyone. Three roles. What are the three roles? Product owner, Scrum Master,
Scrum Master, and Team Developer.
Okay. Then we have five events. What are the five events? Sprint planning. Okay.
Sprint retrospective.
Backlog.
Sprint review meeting.
Three artifacts: product backlog, sprint backlog,
product backlog, sprint backlog,
product increment. Okay.
Product increment.
Okay. This is a cheat sheet of Scrum. You can also go through it. Okay. Yeah, this task board is a good thing to understand. So who made, this is a complete, someone made it from, I think Farhan, you made it. Yeah, Farhan is gone, but Farhan made it. It's an excellent sheet. It summarized everything in Scrum. Someone made this one. This is also excellent to go through the Scrum. Okay, this cheat sheet someone shared in the group. Now, this is very important. You have team roles. You can get a questions. Please clarify these roles. This is a complete process, task board, but this actually gives each and everything about Scrum. Bio?
Hello?
Yeah. I need you to go through this cheat sheet two or three times. Okay? Everyone,
okay.
I need you to read this cheat sheet 2 to 3 times to get it into your bones. Okay?
Yeah.
Especially this one.
Okay.
Then this is sprint retrospective. I made this one. Okay. XP already is clear to us. Now you see, now this also, summarize what you guys have also seen. Another way to see. Okay. This is task board. Hassan, here you see, we have limited.
Yep.
It is not compulsory that we only limit work in progress. We can limit anything. But we have to limits, okay? These 7 ways of lean we have discussed, okay? Okay, Kaizen is continuous improvement. Just give me a 2 minute.